The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Mary set out and traveled to the hill country in haste to a town of Judah, where she entered the house of Zechariah and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the infant leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth, filled with the Holy Spirit, cried out in a loud voice and said, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb. And how does this happen to me, that the mother of my Lord should come to me? For at the moment the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the infant in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed are you who believe that what was spoken to you by the Lord would be fulfilled." And Mary said, "My soul proclaims the greatness of the Lord. My spirit rejoices in God my Savior, for he has looked with favor on his lowly servant. From this day all generations will call me blessed. The Almighty has done great things for me, and holy is his name. He has mercy on those who fear him in every generation. He has shown the strength of his arm, and has scattered the proud in their conceit. He has cast down the mighty from their thrones, and has lifted up the lowly. He has filled the hungry with good things, and the rich he has sent away empty. He has come to the help of his servant Israel, for he has remembered his promise of mercy, the promise he made to our fathers, to Abraham and his children forever." Mary remained with her after about three months, and then returned to her home. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Magandang umaga po sa inyong lahat. This morning, I got a question. Father, is today a holiday of obligation? Is the solemnity of the Assumption of Mary a holiday of obligation? Sa Pilipinas po, hindi. Sa Pilipinas, hindi. Ano? We only have three holidays of obligation. January 1, the Solemnity of Mary, the Mother of God. December 8, the Immaculate Conception. And December 25, the Birth of Christ. Sa Pilipinas, ano pa? Sa ibang bansa, assumptions and other solemnities about Mary are considered holiday of obligation. But it's still good to go to church. One of the most important questions, perhaps good to ask today, is what are you hoping for? What are you hoping for? Do you hope for heaven? Do you hope for heaven? Kayo ba'y nangangarap tungkol sa langit? If not, what are your hopes? Or what are you hoping for? Then I would directly, bluntly tell you, without the hope of heaven, everything is a waste. Without heaven, everything is a waste. Think about it. Think about it. If there's no heaven, then every day, everyone will die, and it will be the end of everything. Para saan pa? Hindi po ba, ano? Para saan pa? saan pa ang pagluha pag mayroong pumapanaw? Ang pagluha mo ba ay dahil hindi na kayo magkikita? Or kasama sa iyong pangarap na pagdating ng araw, magkikita-kita muli ang mga taong nagmamahal sa isa't isa? Without heaven, life is completely a waste. The dogma of the assumption is that simply Mary going up to heaven is spared from the corruption of death. But it is a promise that someday we will be where Mary have gone. That's the second reading is all about. Christ came through Mary and Christ has conquered death that we may have eternal life. Some people ask the question, Father, si Mary po ba namatay o natulog lang? It was the question being asked to the late Saint John Paul II, now Saint. Sabi niya, the question is irrelevant. The question is irrelevant. Natulog lang ba o namatay? The dogma is not about natulog or namatay. The dogma is that Mary assumed into heaven body and soul. That is our hope. Someday I will assume to heaven. Assume. Ano po pinakaiba ng ascension sa assumption? Today, we are celebrating assumption. It is by the power of God that Mary assumed into heaven. It is by His own power that Jesus ascended. Magkaiba po yun. Ano po? The ascension is by the power of God that He brought Himself to heaven. Assumption is by the power of God that Mary went to heaven. We will not ascend. We will simply assume by the power of God. My dear friends, my brothers and sisters, kaya nga, madalas ko pong sinasabi kung walang pangarap, walang bukas. Lahat tayo mabubulok lang. Sayang naman, di po ba? No? Aanuhin niyang pinaghihirapan mo. Aanuhin niyang pinagsusumikapan mo. Aanuhin niyang pagdadasal mo na ikaw ay gumaling. Aanuhin niyong pagpapakabuti kung wala naman tayong pag-asang magkikita-kita muli sa langit. The first reading reminds us of what? Of the prophecy of this, about this woman who will be crowned in heaven. One of the dogma is what? The coronation of Mary. Sinong kukoronahan mo doon kung hindi naman umakyat sa langit? Hindi po ba? Mayroong kang umakyat dahil mayroong kinukoronahan. Or mayroong kinukoronahan dahil mayroong umakyat. It's simple logic. It is a simple logic. And the gospel speaks of what? In spite of being the mother of God, Mary never boast, but simply express her gratitude. Sabi nga, ang utang na loob ay hindi nababayaran, ito ay tinatanaw. The Magnificat is an expression of gratitude. Sino ba naman ako? Yun ang sinasabi ni Maria sa kanya sarili. Sino ba naman ako? Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, sadyang ang merong higit na mababang loob, ang higit na tinatanghal. Inuulit ko, ang sinumang higit na may mababang loob ay higit na tinatanghal. Those who are truly humble are the one being exalted. Sapagkat sadyang magkaiba ang pamantayan ng Diyos sa pamantayan ng tao. Ano po? Yesterday, in the Vigil Mass, the first reading speaks of the Ark of the Covenant. The Ark of the Covenant. But the New Testament speaks of Mary as the new Ark of the Covenant. Ano po ba yung Ark of the Covenant? Doon nakalagay yung remnants ng 10 utos ng Diyos. Remnants, ibig sabihin yung natira, ano po, nilagay nila sa isang tabernakulo at iniingatan nila dahil yan ay isang bagay na talagang galing sa Diyos. Sino mas mahalaga? Yung regalo o ang nagbigay ng regalo? Sino mas mahalaga? Ang regalo o ang nagbigay ng regalo? Ang malungkot na kwento, mas mahalaga sa atin ngayon ang regalo kaysa sa nagbigay ng regalo. Hindi po ba, ano? Isa sa malaking iskandalo ay ano, dapat mahalin mo ang tao, gamitin mo ang gamit. Love people and use things. The modern scandal is some people use people and love things. Yan ang malungkot na kwento. Dapat minamahal mo ang tao at ginagamit mo ang gamit. Ang malungkot na kwento sa panahon natin ngayon, ginagamit ko ang tao dahil mahal ko ang gamit. Mga minamahal na mga kapatid, if you don't hope for heaven, what are you hoping for? Amen.
If the people in the Old Testament value so much the Ark of the Covenant, the New Testament, let us not forget that Mary is the new Ark of the Covenant. In her womb, it was not the stones that contained it, but the very Christ, the incarnate Son, our Lord Jesus. Huwag nating kakalimutan yun. Ano po? Nasa sinapupunan ni Maria, ang Diyos ay nagkatawang tao. Sometimes, many of our non-Catholic brothers would castigate us. Why do you honor or why do you give Mary so much reverence? And my simple answer is, even God need a woman to be human. Ang Diyos ay nangailangan ng isang babae para siya'y maging tao. At ang babaeng iyon, ang pangalan ay Maria. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you and your family, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace to love and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.